Hello everyone. We are happy to announce that GeoStudio 2021.4 is now available. This video summarizes the key features and improved functionality that is part of this GeoStudio release. The GeoStudio 2021.4 release continues advancing the digital twin by introducing interoperability between 3D geological modeling and 2D geotechnical analysis. First, you can create multiple sections in your Leapfrog geological models and upload them to Sequence Collaboration Tool Central, or export them as a DXF or DWG file from your third-party CAD software. In this release, you can now import these sections into Build3D using the new Import Sections feature. This feature allows you to choose the sections you want to import, transform them to the Y elevation coordinate required in Build3D, and import the material list automatically assigned to your sections. You can then modify the sections directly in Build3D or generate 2D geometries to create your numerical analyses. Dynamic updating between your source file or central and the 2D imported sections is also available. GeoStudio 3D Flow combines the all-new CTRAN3D and AIR3D analyses with SEEP3D and TEMP3D. Now you can analyze your environmental protection, groundwater flow, and ground freezing problems in both 2D and 3D. The true power of GeoStudio 3D Flow is unlocked when you apply multiple physics to your model domain through coupling between each of the analysis types. For example, CTRAN3D can be coupled to SEEP3D to consider complex advection dispersion systems with first-order reactions, like this example of solute transport from a pond into the underlying soil. The capabilities of our last two releases of the newly reformulated SigmaW stress strain analyses have been improved further with the expansion of our material model library to include the soft soil cap model. This new material model is similar to the modified CAM clay model, except that it behaves better for over-consolidated soils. Improvements have also been made to the SANICLAY material model to address issues with the original 2006 formulation. These improvements ensure that the failure state is no longer a function of anisotropy. Improvements have been made to the Build3D UI UX. First, you can now visualize the quality of your fitted surface to the original input data points using color-coded distance parameters. When importing a surface as a background mesh, either through Central or a CAD source file, there is now an option to automatically adjust the base point of your import to the surface's minimum extents. This improves the workflow when remapping your axes from a Z elevation coordinate to the GeoStudio Y elevation coordinate. To aid in understanding meshing errors in Build3D, we have now added a feature that allows you to select the geometry objects that are causing the mesh error. This new feature is available in the Task Manager window of Build3D. That concludes our review of the new features and improved functionality available in GeoStudio 2021.4. Visit our What's New page for full release notes. If you have any questions, please contact the GeoStudio sales team or submit technical questions through our online support portal. Thank you for watching and enjoy using GeoStudio 2021.4.